When great love twists into hot dispute, unscathed is naught of that amorous root. Oberon, lord of the forest, wild with rage, had Albrook swell to proud flooding stage. Titania, his queen, angers him again, sending hail on the crops in a dashing rain. Disaster looms where'er the couple meets, unreconciled they part, with scant relief. Their quarrel, an eternal source of sorrow for man and beast.
Oh, Miss Anne, what brings you here?
I came with Father to see how your rehearsals are faring, Master William.
As we see, the prospects are good. A fine epilogue you've got there. It reminds bride and groom not to sacrifice love to quarreling, though it's always a part of marriage.
Glad I be, dear Ferdinando, if I only had an epilogue by now. But what you've just heard is merely the prelude to the play.
Now, now, if you're already off to a strong start, the better you'll end it. Put your mind at rest, my friend. You'll have the celebrants lying at your feet.
For me, a standing ovation would be quite sufficient.
You'll get one, don't you worry. Simply carry on the way you've begun. And we don't want to get in your way any longer, either.
Kind friend, nothing could be further from the truth. You're no obstacle to me. You're the greatest help I've ever had in London. And the same goes for your daughter.
Though I'm rarely cheap with good advice and poor rhyme, here they offer you nearly nothing. And I've been asked to see the king.
But Father...
Thank you. Thank you.